William C. Brown originally proposed and was the first to use microwaves for WPT in 1964 on the CBS Walter Cronkite News. He demonstrated a microwave-powered helicopter that received all the power needed for flight from a microwave beam. Key to this flight was the Rectenna, which absorbed the microwave beam and simultaneously converted it to DC power. In the 1969 to 1975 time period, Bill Brown managed a program that increased the overall efficiency to a JPL certified efficiency of 54%. He also beamed power over a distance of 1 mile to a Rectenna, which intercepted a portion of the beam and converted it to 30 kilowatts of DC power with 84% efficiency.
The technology of wireless power transmission is not without precedent. Significant demonstrations and verifications of electric power transfer efficiency and high power delivery at long range have been accomplished by NASA. The most dramatic of these was the NASA JPL Goldstone demonstration conducted in 1975, in which 34,000 watts of power was safely transmitted over 1.5 kilometers at an efficiency of greater than 82%. It was then, and remains today, what can be called the world record for high-power, long-distance wireless power transmission. The NASA JPL Venus Station 26-meter antenna, with its 500,000-watt transmitter, was used to perform a 1.54-kilometer wireless power transmission to a Rectenna array located on the Goldstone site's collimation tower. 4,590 Rectenna elements with high-efficiency gallium arsenide diodes were fabricated at the Raytheon Microwave and Power Tube Lab and assembled in Rectenna subarrays of about 1 meter square. From each DC output of the 17 subarrays, approximately one-third of the power was routed to a pair of 300-watt lamps. The lamps were arranged in the geometry of the Rectenna array and wired to corresponding positions such that illumination of the lights would represent the received power beam at the Rectenna. Of the calibrated RF power flux density that fell on the 24 square meter Rectenna array on June 5, 1975, 82.5% was collected and converted to direct current output.
It can be seen from the results of the successful 54% end-to-end laboratory demonstration of wireless power transmission and the successful test at Goldstone of sending 34 kilowatts at a mile range that we can confidently predict the performance of a wireless power transmission system, whether it be direct or laser or microwave or with relays, and this technology should help NASA have successful missions in the future.
In 1987, a Canadian project successfully flew an 1/8 fuelless unmanned airplane prototype called S.H.A.R.P. which was powered by microwave energy transmitted from the ground for 20 minutes at an altitude of about 150 meters. The program intended to develop an economical, long-endurance, high-altitude platform to float unmanned lightweight aircraft for long periods, circling at an altitude of about 21 kilometers for the purpose of relaying radio communications signals over a wide area. A similar project was carried out in Japan in the early 1990s called SRRS. The objectives of the SRRS were similar to those of the Canadian SH.A.R.P., where they experimented with a less than 4 kilogram lightweight bolster aircraft with a 2.5 meter wingspan called Milax. Milax flew successfully for 40 seconds and covered a distance of 400 meters over a straight course where the transmitter system was installed on the roof of the car. We have now reached a frequency of 2.45 GHz, which is part of the microwave S-band of the electromagnetic spectrum. Microwaves are usually defined as electromagnetic energy ranging from approximately 1 GHz to 170 GHz in frequency. For the following experiments, I have used a standard microwave oven that was modified by replacing the standard door micro switches with a relay, reverse circuit 5.0. with additional warning bezels and safety controls. The cavity and waveguide was removed and replaced with a new horn waveguide attached directly to the magnetron, refer circuit 5.1. A horn waveguide uses gradual geometry changes that provide the waveguide an impedance match between the waveguide itself and free space by gradually expanding the waveguide dimensions. The waves correspond to the wavelengths which are reinforced by constructive interference after many reflections from the cavity's reflecting surfaces. Similar experiments are then performed as those previously shown, using a simple dipole in free space using two quarter wave dipoles or a half a wave length coil with the addition of a Schottky diode for rectification and a light source tapped in the center of two quarter wave coils. Lighting a simple LED, reverse circuit 5.2 tuned to 2.45 GHz, where a full wavelength of the distance that a single wave travels is approximately 12.2 centimeters. At its peak or quarter wavelength, the two dipole antenna lengths of wire are only 3 centimeters each when extended to a straight wire length, therefore very compact. Please note that the wiring to the dipole becomes part of the antenna, therefore has to be tuned to work optimally. A standard 240-volt 100-watt AC mains GLS light source can also be illuminated without an aerial, demonstrating the inductive effects of high frequency as a filament, a length of wire is partially tuned to the wavelength transmitted when held within the electromagnetic field. Ideally, the full length of the filament wire should be substantially less than one half the wavelength of the radiation concerned. The impedance includes reactance, and reactance creates effects which vary with frequency due to inductance and capacitance. Gas discharge light sources such as fluorescent light sources will also illuminate brightly and can therefore be designed to be tuned to a specific wavelength. A simple Rectenna is constructed from Schottky diodes placed between antenna dipoles, refer circuit 5.2, showing a single element. The diode rectifies the current induced in the antenna by the microwave transmitter. Schottky diodes are used because they have the lowest voltage drop and highest speed and therefore waste the least amount of power due to conduction and switching. It is the DC power from each element that is combined, refer to circuit 5.2, by parallel or series wiring, achieving an antenna whose radiation pattern is no more directional than a dipole over a ground plane with a large collecting aperture. Successful flights are now shown with a Rectenna from a group of individual antenna dipoles as per circuit 5.3, parallel together to power a small electrical pager motor powered helicopter wirelessly.